Walter Zolna presents. A Gator Films production. Adventure begins.
Good morning once again. Welcome to Berks County, Pennsylvania. We are on the Appalachian Trail. It's a few minutes after sunrise here, and we are going to be doing the Pinnacle and the Pulpit Loop Hike, one of the most popular trails in eastern Pennsylvania. We're off to an early start. It's about 17, 18 degrees, but it's a beautiful winter day. We're going to have some blue skies, some amazing views. This is a really wonderful hike, and I've been saving this one up for a while. So we're about to start a climb of about 700 feet to the first overlook known as Pulpit Rock. And I'll catch up with you ahead. Thanks for joining me. I do appreciate you. Now let's hit that trail. All right, guys, Gator out. There's absolutely nothing better than being out at first light in the morning. Especially in the winter, it's so quiet. I've seen a beautiful fox. When I first got to the trail, it was still dark out. And believe it or not, there was actually two hikers sitting in their car when I pulled up about 6:45 this morning. So, like I said, it's a popular trail. And you gotta hit these popular trails sometimes on days like today if you wanna have a little bit of privacy on the trail. Coming into this field of very large rocks, and that's how you know you're starting to get close to Pulpit Rock. There's a very noisy pileated woodpecker flying around above me. The sun's temporarily gone behind a cloud, but it'll come back out. About 4 to 6 inches of snow on the mountain here, but the trail's pretty well broken in, so it's really not that bad. All right, we are continuing our way up to the Pulpit Rock. The trail's become a very rocky, narrow, somewhat treacherous footpath here with the snow and ice, so gotta be careful here. But once we get through this little rough stretch, we should have an amazing view, perfect place to take a break. So good stuff ahead. It's an absolutely gorgeous view here from the Pulpit Rock, but the winds up here are absolutely fierce. I tried to put the drone up, I almost lost it. It must be gusting up to 35, 40 miles an hour. Wind chill is probably in the single digits. My hands were frozen. But man, what a beautiful, peaceful place. Look at that view out there. It's Pennsylvania perfect. So I made myself some nice Campbell's chicken noodle soup, red can, original, old style, this morning at about 4:30 in the morning. And I'm gonna have some of that now, and that should warm me up, hopefully. It is freezing up here at the Pulpit. Oh, that is good. Oh, man, I hit the spot. Now, looking at the mountain that way, we'll be following along the ridgeline there on our hike. And then right where the mountain drops off, that is going to be the pinnacle, which is said to be the best viewpoint on the Appalachian Trail in Pennsylvania. So I've done this hike a few times before, and it is spectacular. Personally, I like this view better, but most people like the other view. But you let me know in the video, in the comments, which ones you think is better. So here at the top of the mountain is a little astronomical observatory, the Lehigh Valley Amateur Astronomical Society. So another way to come up to the top of the mountain here is a small gravel road, or you could take the AT like we did, but the wind out here is so fierce. It's like, I feel like I'm in Antarctica though, with the snow blowing around. It's awesome. I've put an extra layer back on to keep my head warm. Your extremities, your head, your toes, your feet, the most important things to protect in this kind of weather. And look, we're not climbing Mount Everest here, but we have temperatures here where you could get frostbite. It could be potentially dangerous or life-threatening. So when you come out on days like this, dot your I's, cross your T's, make a list, make sure you have everything you need. I'm a big proponent of the layering system. If I get too hot, I can take a layer off. I have an emergency extra layer in my pack. I have gloves, I have hand warmers, I have fire starting equipment. If for some reason I got stuck out here, and I'll be fine, but you just take a little bit extra precaution when you come out on a day like today. This next section of the trail, from what I remember, is very, very rocky, and so far that is bearing out to be the case. But it's going to be about somewhere between 1.5 to 2 miles till we reach the pinnacle overlook, but it's going to be slow going here, so gotta watch your step, especially with all the snow and the ice underneath the snow and the rocks. A twisted ankle, or worse, a broken leg, something like that, would not be good out here right now. So, take your time. Mm-hmm. So being up here in these conditions reminds me of a time when I came hiking here with my brother. It was a late winter, early spring day, warm. Started out around 30, ended up being, it was gonna be highs in like the mid 50s. So we got off to our early start. There was trace amount of snow on the ground at the base of the mountain. Whoa. But at the top of the mountain, there was like 8 to 10 inches of snow and it was all melting, so it was wet and there was a layer of crust, and with every step you'd fall through, sink into the snow. All right, fine. So we did our hike. It was cool. We had a good time. But the point is, when we got back to the parking lot, by then it was midday. There was a bunch of day hikers making their way up the mountain. So we saw a group of like young girls, like teenage girls, 14, 15 years old. And a couple of them were wearing like shorts, like soccer shorts, like Umbros and sneakers and ankle socks with a little hoodie sweatshirt. And me and my brother looked at each other and we said, oh my God, do they know what they're getting into up there? Should we say something? What do we do? They're gonna have to turn around. And I'll never forget that. But I think the reason I'm bringing that up is because at the base of the mountain, it was pretty calm and pretty quiet. But up here, the wind is whipping and, you know, only 800 feet. But when you're at the ridge line, it can make a big difference. Elevation and, you know, where you are in the mountains can make a big difference. So, you know, you always want to be overprepared rather than underprepared. But I'll never forget that. Never forget that. It's that, those poor girls heading up the mountain. All right, continuing on. This is the view from Pulpit Rock on the Appalachian Trail, March 2014. About a foot of snow cover on the mountain here. We got the whole place to ourselves.
Wally and Nitro.
Absolutely beautiful. We have finally made it to the pinnacle, and this little footpath is going to take us out to a viewpoint right at the edge of the mountain. We're going to have a view of more than 180 degrees. Truly, truly one of the iconic viewpoints in the state of Pennsylvania here at the Pinnacle. It's absolutely breathtaking, and the snow really just adds that much more to it, making it feel like a totally wild, wild experience up here. Wow, totally awesome. As my friend Dave would say, B-E-A-utiful. I met a fellow hiker on a trail here, friendly young gentleman named Greg.
How you doing?
And we're below the pinnacle here, and he's showing me the way into the Pinnacle Cave, which I've heard about. So we're gonna take a look in there now. It's super cool. It's nice and dry in here. Hopefully no bears. And wow. This is a real pleasant surprise. I was wondering about this location, but I didn't want to try finding it on my own. Then Greg and a couple of his friends showed up, and he was kind enough to show me the way in here. Wow, look at this. Whole nother world. Now, I understand in this area in the summertime, you will find copperheads and some rattlesnakes, but no worry about that this time of year. How many times have you been in this cave before?
Probably a dozen or so.
Dozen, right.
Yeah, it turns back there and it keeps going. You can crawl back as far as you want to go.
Okay. So you come down a main passage of about, I'd say that's about what, 30 feet?
Yeah.
Then it makes a left turn and it starts getting a lot more narrow. But you can keep going in there, certainly. Pinnacle Snow Cave. Really making this adventure something special. Awesome stuff here in SCENIC, Pennsylvania.
Nice meeting you.
You too, Greg.
Have
thank you.
Have a good
you.
Rest of your trip, man.
How's it going?
You guys be safe.
You too.
Nice meeting you. Thank you. Take care.
You
right. What an awesome spot. That was really cool. Again, meeting Greg and his two friends, and had a nice little dog that looked like a little polar bear. And that cave was something else. That was pretty cool. I was hoping to get in there, but I wasn't going to try it on my own. I mean, what a beautiful spot. I mean, Pennsylvania, perfect. Doesn't get any better than that, guys. Good stuff. Well, that is the spectacular Pinnacle overlook here on the Appalachian Trail, reputed to be the best view on the Appalachian Trail in Pennsylvania. And I think they got a pretty good case. I think you're gonna be hard pressed to beat this one. Picture, postcard perfect. And we're now pretty much at the halfway point of the hike, so we're going to be going back now on the mountain on the other side of the ridge. And I won't be filming too much in this section till we get to a point where we're gonna bear off the Appalachian Trail, and then the trail follows a creek for a little bit. So I'll probably pick up there. So we've now come to the location known as the helipad, and right behind here is a sign letting you know that we're in the headwaters of the Furnace Creek watershed. So we're at the top of the mountain. We're here. Okay, here's the pulpit. We started down here, we came up this way. All right, there's the pinnacle. We're now here. And we're now going to follow this little trail along Furnace Creek back to where we started to complete the hike. So we should have a nice little creekside hike for the rest of the way. And so this water from this mountain and this creek will eventually reach the Schuylkill River, the Delaware River, and ultimately into the Atlantic Ocean. Just really, really pretty nature shots and scenery here along Furnace Creek. This is really winter hiking at its finest. Forest here is beautiful. Sounds lovely. It's perfect. All right, we've now arrived at the Hamburg Reservoir here at the base of the mountain. So we're actually not far from the car now. We just passed through that wonderful stretch of trail and the reservoir is our last main point of interest. I'll show you that in a second. But my knees are starting to feel it in my knees anyway. So I think I've about had enough. All right, my friends, that's going to do it for the hike today. This time from the Pulpit Rock Pinnacle Overlook Loop here in Berks County. As I said, one of the most popular hikes in certainly in eastern Pennsylvania. Two beautiful views. We got down to the cave. That was awesome. Thank you to the young man who guided me down there. Really appreciate that. And finished up with a nice walk along Furnace Creek. Beautiful final leg, and then the reservoir there. So that's about it. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. It means a lot to me. It means a lot for the algorithm. It can help the channel grow. You'd be supporting me a lot by doing that. And if you have any comments or questions, let me know down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Been very busy lately, but I will get back to you. So that's about it, guys. And thanks, I appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next one. All right, Gator out.